In October, Hamas attacked Israel, killing more than 1,000 people and taking hundreds of hostages. Among those held and thought to still be alive are 5 Americans. Israel's response has killed thousands of Palestinians and created a humanitarian crisis in Gaza. President Biden, you've put forward a proposal to resolve this conflict, but so far Hamas has not released the remaining hostages, and Israel is continuing its military offensive in Gaza. So what additional leverage will you use to get Hamas and Israel to end the war? You have 2 minutes.
Number one, everyone from the United Nations Security Council straight through to the G7 to the Israelis and Netanyahu himself have endorsed the plan I put forward, which has 3 stages to it. The first stage is trade the hostages for a ceasefire. Second phase is a ceasefire with additional conditions. The third phase is the end of the war. The only one who wants the war to continue is Hamas, number one. They're the only ones standing out. We're still pushing hard to get them to accept. In the meantime, what's happened? In Israel, we're finding that the only thing I've denied Israel was 2,000-pound bombs. They don't work very well in populated areas. They kill a lot of innocent people. We're providing Israel with all the weapons they need and when they need them. And by the way, I'm the guy that organized the world against Iran when they had a full-blown intercontinental ballistic missile attack on Israel. No one was hurt. No one Israeli was accidentally killed, and it stopped. We saved Israel. We are the biggest producer of support for Israel of anyone in the world. And so there are 2 different things. Hamas cannot be allowed to continue. We continue to send our experts and our intelligence people as to how they can get Hamas like we did bin Laden. You don't have to do it. And by the way, they've been greatly weakened, Hamas, greatly weakened, and they should be. They should be eliminated. But you've got to be careful for what using certain weapons among population centers.
Just going back to Ukraine for 1 second. We have an ocean separating us. The European nations together have spent $100 billion or maybe more than that, less than us. Why doesn't he call them and say, you got to put up your money like I did with NATO? I got them to put up hundreds of billions of dollars. The Secretary General of NATO said Trump did the most incredible job I've ever seen. They wouldn't have any. They were going out of business. We were spending almost 100% of the money was paid by us. He didn't do that. He's getting all. You got to ask these people to put up the money. We're over $100 billion more spent, and it has a bigger impact on them because of location, because we have an ocean in between. You got to ask them. As far as Israel and Hamas, Israel's the one that wants to go. He said the only one that wants to keep going is Hamas. Actually, Israel is the one, and you should let him go and let him finish the job. He doesn't want to do it. He's become like a Palestinian. But they don't like him because he's a very bad Palestinian. He's a weak one.